This is Praise Channel TV. You are welcome. Pursue and take it back. Pursue and take it back. Shortly after this time of prayer on Praise Channel TV. Father, I give you praise. Jesus, I give you glory. I appreciate you, Abba Father. I appreciate you, Ancient of Days, for this golden and marvelous opportunity you've given us one more time to share on this platform. May you breathe afresh upon me, O Lord. Release your grace, your anointing, your power to make this ministration very easy for me. I receive the unction to function unto your glory. Holy Spirit, I depend on you. Use me to your glory, Lord. Have your way, Father. I have prayed in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Pursue and take it back. I'm so glad to welcome you one more time to Praise Channel TV. I appreciate you for your time. You keep coming to this channel, and I appreciate you. If you are coming for the first time, you are welcome. This is the channel that God has instituted himself to bring about hope, salvation, and encouragement to the world. You are blessed and highly favored. My name is Evangelist Chuks Chidubeke, Praise Channel. This kind God, your host on this platform. All right. If you have not subscribed to this channel, please click on the red subscribe button, hit the bell sign, and like the channel, and leave a comment with us. And also, you can also leave a word with me through my social media handles made available there. May God bless you. May God lift you and keep you forever in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. We're back to the word for today. Pursue and take it back. Pursue and take it back. Let's read from the scriptures. 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 1. 3, 4, 6, and 8. 1 Samuel 30, verse 1. Let's read. And it came to pass, when David and his men were come to Ziklag on the third day, that the Amalekites had invaded the south and Ziklag, and smitten Ziklag, and burned it with fire. So David and his men came to the city, and behold, it was burned with fire. And their wives and their sons and their daughters were taken captives. Then David and the people that were with him lifted up their voice and wept until they had no more power to weep. Let's continue. And David was greatly distressed, for the people spake of stoning him, because the soul of all the people were grieved, every man for his sons and his daughters. But David encouraged himself in the Lord his God. And David inquired of the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop? Shall I overtake them? And he answered him, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them, and without fail recover all. Pursue and take it back. Pursue and take it back. There is time for everything in this life. Now is the time to take back all that the forces of evil have stolen from you, especially as the pandemic is being eased off, the lockdown being eased off, life returning to normal. You see that many people have lost a lot. I don't know what you have lost, but I've come as a minister of the gospel to decree and declare over your life that you are recovering all, even in this season, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Go ahead and type in an amen in that comment section. Can you type in, I recover all now? Can you type it in? Type it in. God bless you. I recover all. Yes, type it in agreement. Yes, I'm in agreement with you. You are recovering all now. Look at David. All of a sudden, you see, I tell people, I don't know how evil comes uninvited. You don't have to invite the enemy. You don't even have to do anything bad for the enemy to show up. That is his business. The Bible says that like a roaring lion, he goes about seeking whom he may devour. That is his business. His full-time occupation is to wreak havoc and cause trouble. That's the forces of evil I'm telling you about. But the Lord Jesus said, I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. His plan for you and I is for us to have all-round victory and recovery in all situations, all to his glory, in the mighty name of Jesus. Can I hear you say a big amen? Amen. So the Amalekites and all the enemies of the children of God invaded the camp of the God's children, took their wives, took their children, scattered the city, and just left everything upside down like that. And the people were so grieved and angry that they wanted to stone David. You know, as a leader, you take the blow when there is a blow. You take the responsibility for anything that has not gone well. So they came after David to stone him to death, as if he was the reason behind what happened. But thank God, God helped him. Number one, he encouraged himself in the Lord. That's the first thing I want to leave with you today. In every situation, when things go awry and bad and sad and negative, please, step one, encourage yourself in the Lord. You see, this word is for believers, because if you are not a believer, you cannot encourage yourself in the person you don't know. So if you are a child of God, if you are not, I will soon lead you to Christ, to Jesus, to give your life to Jesus and be born again. So he encouraged himself in the Lord. And when he did this, that was when he went to the Lord after encouraging himself in him and asked, shall I pursue after this troop? The word of yesterday is not enough for today. The word of today will not be sufficient for tomorrow. So the mercy of the Lord, they are new every morning. So today, the fresh grace you are receiving today is for you to arise, to pursue and take back what the enemy has stolen. And when David asked the Lord this question, the Lord answered him and said, the Bible says, and he answered, that's Jehovah, he answered David and said, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake them and without fail recover all. When you get a word from the Lord, you will go after what your heart desire is boldly, because the word of God brings courage and boldness, and it knocks off fear. So David arose and he went after this. Of course, the rest of the story is that victory was won. It's time for you to arise, pursue, and take back what the enemy has stolen in your family, in your career, in your ministry, in your business, in your relationship, in your marriage, in your health, in your spiritual life, in your finances, in your social activities. Whatever the enemy has stolen, it's time to arise and take them all back. This is the time. Don't wait for anybody to do it for you. I came today to provoke you, child of God, that enough is enough. The time has come for you to arise and take back what they have taken from you. And you have what it takes, because with God, all things are possible, and we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. And I tell you that if you are not able to pursue and take back what is yours, the Lord will not encourage us to do that in the Bible. And like David, this morning, this day, I want you to be angry with the forces of darkness and arise in anger, because Jesus is with you. And one with God is in the majority. You are not going alone. The Lion of the tribe of Judah is with you, and victory is guaranteed when he's in your boat and in your camp. And if you're a child of God, Jesus is in your camp. Time has come for you to arise. That's what I've come to share with you today. To wake up, stop the forces of darkness, pursue them, stop them, take back what they have taken, stolen from you, because this is the time, because this is the season, and this is the moment, and you have what it takes. Child of God, are you ready to arise and take back what belongs to you? Because if you don't do that, the enemy will continue to have a field day, messing you up, shortchanging you, taking what belongs to you. But if you arise now, when you arise, the Lord will arise with you. And that's the will of God for you, because he desires that you have all-round victory. So even right now, I begin to encourage you. Can you open your mouth and begin to decree and declare over the forces of darkness that have shortchanged you and taken what belongs to you? Begin to bind them and cast them out wherever they have discouraged you, and then run after them right now. Pursue them. Take back your victory. Take back your joy. Take back your relationship. Take back your ministry. Take back your business. Pursue them. Take back your career. Take back your health. Take back your finances. Take back your international open doors. Take back your visa that they have made you to have been denied even up to now. In the mighty name of Jesus, child of God, can you open your mouth and begin to resist the forces of darkness that have been blocking your way as you take back what they have taken from you? Pursue. Take back right now. Open your mouth. I'm doing mine too. Takabataya kasi. Iprasutu vegima. Ipaduduku sikre patoti. Ja. Lagabadia. Asupre kefusita kaida. Rigo patoska. I pursue you and I take back what belongs to me. I pursue you and I take back what belongs to me. In the mighty name of Jesus. Now. Radiba. Dokusila. Imbrosokoto. Enough is enough. Give me back my stuff. Give me back my blessing. Give me back my relationship. Give me back my victory. Give me back my finances. Give me back my job. Give me back my welfare. Give me back everything that belongs to me. Now, I receive and I take them back in the mighty name of Jesus, all to the glory of God. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. That's what you should do even now. Because after this COVID-19 is easing off and the lockdown is being eased off, you see that many people are jobless, many people have lost so much money, many people have lost so much property, many people have lost so much opportunities and several things. But now is the time to take them back. Thank you, Jesus. And now if you are not born again, you have not given your life to Jesus, please, this is the first place to start. I plead with you, please, give your life to Jesus by repeating this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I thank you for dying on the cross for me. Jesus, I receive you now as my personal Lord and Savior. Please forgive me all my sins. Wash me with the blood that you shed on the cross for me. I reject you, Satan, and your demons, and all the forces of darkness that have been working against my life. Now I'm a child of God. Help me, Jesus, to serve you to the end. Thank you, Almighty God. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Amen. Now let me pray for you. Father, thank you for this, your peculiar child that has decided to surrender to you. Lord, may you reign in this life as Lord and Savior forever. And, oh Lord, as you promised, let all the promises you made for to be the portion of those who have given their lives to you follow this one, talking about, of course, salvation, prosperity, open doors, open heavens, increase, breakthrough, miracles, signs and wonders, supernatural protection, supernatural elevation, supernatural intervention and manifestation, international connections. Oh God, release houses, cars into this life, because it says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and other things shall be added unto you. Add the other things unto this one, plus grace unto holiness. Thank you, Lord, for it is done. You are covered with the blood of Jesus. I have prayed in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. It is well with you. God bless you. If you have not subscribed to this channel, please do click on the red subscribe button, click on the bell sign, and like the channel, and of course, leave a message with us. Thank you for your time. God bless you. My name is Evangelist Chuk Chidubeke, Praise Channel. This kind God. Thank you for your time. See you next time. Salute.